Today I'll start my satsang on Madhurayadhinam and its philosophy. As I said earlier, Madhurayadhinam has two parts in its history. Historic period and prehistoric period. Basically, this institution is, this organization is established by Sundareshwara and Meenakshi themselves. It is revived by the great saint Thirunjana Sambandar, an incarnation, a great enlightened being. A high achiever, lived only 16 years on the planet Earth, but finished contributing whatever he wanted to contribute within 16 years, and still the world is remembering him all over. Still, even among the Saiva saints, he is considered to be the greatest. Still, his songs, his sacred sentiments, compilation of his sacred sentiments as the first chapters of Devaram. Devaram is the compilation of a sacred sentiments on Shiva, great, beautiful, very beautiful, sweet expressions of all the different bhavas, the sacred sentiments. His compilations are considered to be the first chapter, and he is the first master led humanity through devotion to Shiva, through understanding to Shiva. After he revived, the Saiva tradition and established this organization from him, number one, to me, 293. This period only we call it as historic period. Means recorded history is available. Before him, from Sundareshwara to Jnana Sambandar. That period only I call it as prehistoric period. Shiva sitting in Samadhi in Kailash. No, this whole history and philosophy of Madhurayadhinam I can condense in four statements. One, the ultimate divine descends in human body and expresses its extraordinary powers and experiences playfully. Sundareshwara is the embodiment of this statement. Sundareshwara is not a serious, please understand. When I describe Sundareshwara, don't understand him as a serious guy with a long matted hair and the snake, Trishul, sitting in Samadhi, always in Kailash, frozen in time. No. Sundareshwara, powerful, playful, divine, above all, handsome, That is why he is called Sundareshwara, Lord of beauty, Lord of handsome. Coming down, selling firewood, selling pearls and diamonds, selling bangles. Destroying all the obstacles happening to the Madurai city and his devotees. I tell you, Sundareshwara is the most powerful living incarnation. Please understand. He is so easily available. Anytime anybody requests, immediately reduces his frequency to human body, walks on the streets of Madurai. I am constantly in ecstasy, just remembering I am sitting in a land which is sanctified by Sundareshwara's feet again and again in human frame. Please understand, in the human body he walked on this land. Each dust of this land is directly sanctified by Mahadeva himself in a very playful dimension. Please understand, not a serious, very distanced, no. He is not like Buddha. If you go to Buddha with the dead body of a child, he will say, go and bring me sesame seed from a house where there is no death happened. Come on, tell me directly, you are not going to revive the child. Why do you want to play all these games? But Sundareshwara, down to earth, he would have just wiped her tears, hugged her, and just sprinkled that very tears on the boy, he would have been alive. Sundareshwara is not a philosopher. He is an artist with tremendous heart, ready to listen to human sufferings, ready to bend for human emotions. He has even gone to the extreme of reviving husband for the sake of second wife, and not only that, coming again to give a witness, the second wife is also, wife also should live with the first wife. He does not judge people. The one and only thing you need to obtain his grace is simple feeling connection. That's all. Nothing else. He does not say, hey, you are doing things against the morality, you are doing things against the society, you are doing things against the dharma, you are doing things against the spiritual philosophy, you are doing things against the prakriti and nature. No, no. Live as per the prakriti and nature, live as per the dharma. No. Nothing. To tell all that, we don't need Sundareshwara. Just this self-declared moral police are enough. He bends for anybody to any level. I was reading all his leelas, recorded leelas, of course. His leelas are innumerable. 63 were recorded. Each leela expresses his dimension. I know for sure the Paranjodhi Munivar, who recorded all these leelas, would have been in a big mess what to leave and what to record. He has chosen one leela to explain one dimension of Sundareshwara. See, compassion has different dimensions and different levels. If I shower my compassion to my disciple, and initiate him into sannyas. That is a different level compassion. I can say it's a kind of an understanding compassion. If I shower my compassion to a disciple and initiate him into an unclutching, that is also kind of an organized compassion. But suddenly somebody who walks in the street heard about me and straight enters into this hall with a fourth stage cancer, I heal him and remove that cancer. That is spontaneous compassion. And there is one more level. Somebody suddenly walks into this hall and says, Swamiji, I sold all my property and drank and enjoyed my life, and I borrowed 10 lakh rupee and spent all that money on womanizing. Now I want money for further womanizing. If I give him 20 lakh, that is Chokanada's compassion. Understand? That is Sundareshwara's compassion. Doesn't bother about anything. Only thing you need, just you need to have a simple feeling connection and you need to ask him. That's it. Sundareshwara's compassion. Even the word compassion is too small. How much he has to go through. What a being. I was reading all the 63 Leelas. You may ask, the books are saying 64. One is not Leela. His presence is recorded as Leela. So 63 are the actions, Leelas. The 64th is his very presence. So the 64th is like a all the said and unsaid Leelas put together is considered as a 64th. 63 are only the actions. So each of his dimension is recorded as one Leela. In Vedic tradition, we have 64 different arts. Each leader, a complete being, has to master that 64 arts. In that, even horse riding is one. Astrology, horse riding, the mastery in medicine, mastery in surgery, mastery in painting, mastery of dance. So each Leela of Sundareshwara proves his mastery on each art. There was never ever such an amazing imagination or visualization of the ultimate without reducing its Ananta Kalyana Gunas into human level. Understand? If you take the ocean water in one cup, all the qualities of the ocean water will not be there in that one cup. Naturally, the life which is in the ocean, its contribution to that water will not be there in the cup water. But the Paranjyoti is a rishi who recorded this whole Leelas. Paranjyoti was capable of bringing all components and dimensions of the ocean into one cup. He was able to describe so beautifully the Leelas. I tell you, yesterday night I decided all the biographies and autobiographies which I have prepared about me has to be dumped. I have to now rewrite completely from new, because the incidents themselves cannot capture the charisma of an enlightened being, an incarnation. The context in which the incident is presented, the understanding with which the happening is shared, that creates the inspiration in the next level human beings to raise themselves to that state. Please understand. Rasalila of Sri Krishna can inspire somebody to be a womanizer, can inspire some women to become beloved of Krishna. The context in which it is presented, the way in which it is shared, the way in which it is taken to human beings, the way in which human beings are taught, decides whether Rasalila is going to create womanizers or enlightened women will be decided only the context in which the whole story is presented. I tell you, Paranjodhi is the best biographer. He has done such a monumental work. I know for sure in front of him at least 100,000 incidents and the leelas would have been there. But he cannot record all the 100,000. People won't have time to read. He has to choose between that 100,000. He has to reduce the 100,000 to 63. Impossible. Which one you will leave and which one you will choose? I tell you, nobody else could have done better job than Paranjodhi. After reading it, me, Sundareshwara, authorizing. And not only that, I am thanking Paranjodhi for the method he created. I am going to write my autobiography in the same form, format, presentation created by Paranjodhi. Because in front of me also thousands of, I don't know, thousands or lakhs or millions of miracles and incidents are there, available. I also don't know which one to record and which one to leave. Now I know what to record, how to record, what to present, how to present. Now I have to rewrite my whole autobiography. Of course, I won't change the facts. I will not change the incidents. But the way it is organized, the choosing, choice of the incidents to be presented, the compilation, God, each incident explains, expresses one extraordinary power Sundareshwara was radiating, one extraordinary experience Sundareshwara was radiating, an extraordinary capability Sundareshwara was radiating. Please understand, capability is not power. Capability is like a circus. By training, it comes. Power comes through training, but not by training. For example, you meditate, meditate, suddenly one day you start levitating. It comes through training, but not by training. Capability means you hang in a rope and try to do yoga, exercise, circus in that rope. By training, 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 you master it so well
just holding the rope with one finger, you are able to hang. This is capability. This comes by training. But you are meditating, 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 suddenly you start levitating. This does not come by training, it comes through training. Means, even if you are getting trained, at one point there will be a breakthrough where beyond what was added will express. That is extraordinary powers. But Paranjyothi is not inhuman fellow. He does not record only extraordinary powers of Sundareshwara. He records extraordinary capabilities of Sundareshwara also. That is why that sweet human touch where Sundareshwara goes and carries mud to embank, to build embankment for this Vaigai. This whole river itself is created by one of his disciple, follower, a Gundodara. The fellow ate too much, ate literally everything during the marriage festival. And he was having hiccups. And his hiccup was like a lightning attacking the whole city. Meenakshi got frightened. As far as I remember, that is the only time she got frightened. So Shiva said, all right, go and put your hand on the ground and water will come. And so Ganga immediately came. And he drank the water and quenched his thirst, whatever. So to build embankment for this Vaigai, he has to carry the sand. All the problems created by disciples, for that he has to carry the sand. Now I can understand. Not just extraordinary powers, his extraordinary capabilities are also beautifully described by Paranjyothi. That is why the human touch, I tell you, just if you read these 63 Leelas, you will have feeling connection to Sundareshwara. This book is like a Kalpataru, because once you have feeling connection for him, he is not a philosopher, understand. As I said now, if somebody comes who sold all the wealth and drank and womanized, made 10 lakh debt, coming and asking Sundareshwara, I wanted to settle my debt and I want more money for womanizing. Give me a few years of life also for womanizing. If Sundareshwara does not have this money, he will go and steal and bring and give. That is Sundareshwara's compassion. He will go in the night, literally using all his powers, open the doors, steal, bring it and give. There are three incidences where Sundareshwara went around stealing is recorded in Thiruvilaiyaadal Puranam. The book describes his leelas. Three times he went around stealing in his own city. He has not left anything undone. But I tell you, there was never ever the sweetest human dimension recorded about the divine without reducing the grandeur and beauty of the divine in the language anywhere on the planet Earth. To compile
the incidents and experiences happened between me and my disciples, I am going to use the pattern, the model of this book, Thiruvilaiyaadar Puranam, which is describing the leelas of Shiva. See, it's like a glory of the vast ocean and sunrise and the shining full moon and the huge Himalayas, the extraordinary Kailash, all these glories, the vast sky, all possible glories expressed in its purest form through the muscles is Sundareshwara. When he sits, it is Kailash. When he walks, it is tsunami. When he turns his eyes, it is eclipse. The beauty of the cosmos in flesh and bones is Sundareshwara. The description does not reduce the divine qualities and grandeur, but does not miss the human touch. Coming down to the ordinary level, he is not available only for pandits and the yogis and meditators. He is available to a drunkard, womanizer, pigs. One pig got killed in the hunting by the king. All the piglets were crying, and he comes as a pig to feed them. God, I cannot imagine. I cannot even imagine this compassion. Means what? This whole area, he decided, in this geography, I'll be available throughout the history and no philosophy. That is Sundareshwara. In this geography, I'll be available throughout the history without any hindrance of philosophy. Over. This is exactly the description of Sundareshwara. No philosophy restriction is philosophy of Madhurya Adhinam. That is the philosophy of Sundareshwara. Down. Assumes human body. Does all legal, illegal, socially accepted, non-accepted, all types of leelas. Not just for his devotees, yogis, rishis, spiritual seekers, no. For drunkards, for prostitutes, for pigs. I can't even put a restriction. If you feel connected, only then he will come. No. I can't imagine pigs felt connected to Sundareshwara and they called, "Oh Sundareshwara, please come and give a milk." No. It is just causeless, purely reasonless. I bow down to the pure love and compassion of Sundareshwara. The four statements I wanted to make at the beginning of the satsang, I made only one statement. I'll make three other statements in next satsangs. Causeless, reasonless expression of the divine, not only in human form, in any form. He came down as pig. Female pig to feed the piglets. I bow down to his compassion
and his grace. O Sundareshwara, let your grace be on all of us.
Paramahamsa Nityananda, a rare living incarnation, is named among the world's 100 most spiritually influential personalities today. Paramahamsa Nityananda has been placed alongside Dalai Lama, Nelson Mandela, Oprah Winfrey, Paulo Coelho and others by Mind, Body, Spirit, the world's top esoteric magazine from Watkins, London's oldest and largest bookstore. A yogi by birth, he has been expressing his power of enlightenment since birth. He has authored more than 500 books in Tamil and English. Translations of these books are available in 26 languages in Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, Hindi, Sanskrit, Gujarati, Oriya, Bengali, Marathi, French, Malay, Polish, Portuguese, Italian, German, Danish, Spanish, Russian, and Chinese. He is also an exemplary speaker with over 10,000 hours of profound life solutions through his discourses. Social services such as Annadan, free medical care, free educational services with ashrams, schools, temples, hospitals established in more than 140 places around the world, offering exceptional services. A powerful spiritual healer who has healed millions of people of diseases from migraine to cancer. A Kriya Yogi who has formulated Kriyas for physical health and mental well-being benefiting thousands. A living master who offers practical solutions for our everyday problems. He is the founder and spiritual head of Nityananda Dhyanapitam, a spiritual powerhouse who has revived the sacred Vedic tradition by establishing Vedic temples in places like Los Angeles, San Jose, Seattle, Toronto, Ohio, Oklahoma, Phoenix, St. Louis, Malaysia, Brazil, Paris, Guadeloupe, Dallas, New York, New Jersey, Atlanta, Calgary, Vancouver, Singapore, and places in India like Bengaluru, Hyderabad, Tiruvannamalai. A spiritual guru for 10 million followers, an incarnation who transmits the highest spiritual energy through initiation, a contemporary yogi who has revived the Vedic science of yoga worldwide through thousands of yoga centers, an adept in Ashtamahasiddhis, mystical yogic powers, who has effortlessly awakened the kundalini of thousands and graced them with spiritual powers, a dynamic young guru who is an inspiration for thousands of youngsters, India's most watched spiritual guru online, a beacon of spiritual light who has triumphed over the forces of religious terrorism and political persecution. Paramahamsa Nityananda is an eternal Kalpataru, blessing the world with the boons of material abundance and spiritual enlightenment. He is the 293rd pontiff of the world's most ancient Hindu organization, Madurai Adinam. Nityanandaya swagatam, anandanubhavaswadam, sarvaroganivarakam, vande papa vinashaktam. Nityanandaya swagatam, nityamuktam nirvikalpam, dhyanaloka pradipakam, vande shantamayam bandham.